Ladies and gentlemen, and everyone else, the legendary, the notorious level 13, Unduke the Bump, welcome to the next stage. Finally made it past level 12. It was a tough ride, but I knew we could pull through. This is, I think it's called an Otiug. Or an Otiug. I don't remember. The manual gives a pronunciation, but I forget what it was. Don't remember anything about it, except... Whoa! I believe that is a wyvern. Or possibly a wyvern. Yeah, an apple. Oh yeah, you mean the grave mist that I fought like 8 levels ago? Pro tip, guys, you need a magical weapon to deal with a grave mist. Important knowledge. So yeah, I'm feeling pretty good. That last video got a little rough in parts, but we pulled through in the end. And now, not really sure what to expect on this level, but it can't possibly be as bad as the fears. I have to say, no, it's bad to... Bad to get overconfident, but I don't think these monsters are going to be as much of a threat as the monsters on the previous level. So far. I mean, I don't know, they might have, like, an instant death attack. Or something. Something horrible. But, so far they don't seem to be doing that much. Okay, that wyvern did a fair bit of damage. But both of the monsters seem pretty slow, and they seem pretty easy to hit. They don't seem to have many hit points. Which are the qualities that I look for in a monster. If I posted an ad on Craigslist that said, in search of monster, My three qualifications would be: must be slow, must be easy to hit, must not have that many hit points. Sorry if that makes me discriminatory against tough, fast monsters, but just how I roll. That's not a thing, is it? No, just a decoration. Which way was I walking? Oh, yeah. You know, I don't think I'd eat an apple that was sitting out in a dungeon 13 levels below the surface. Oh, it's another one of those no magic zones that has the strange tingling thing again. That's interesting. Good thing my hammer doesn't disappear when I walk into that zone. That would be a bummer. Excuse me. Tried to move away from the microphone for that one, but that was extremely loud to people wearing headphones. I apologize. By the way, I have my air conditioner on because it got pretty warm in here. So apologies if there's a lot of background noise. Hopefully the noise gate that I enabled for my microphone will help mitigate the background noise a little bit. Okay, well, I guess it's time to start looking for secrets, since there's nowhere else to go that's obvious. I have True Seeing on, so if there are any illusionary walls, then I should be able to see them, no problem. I'm pretty sure that unless you're in a dark area, you can always see illusionary walls when True Seeing is on. I don't think there are any situations where it fails. Kinda weird how these enemies just spawned out of nowhere. I mean, I just went through that area a second ago and there was nothing there. Also, no projectiles. That's not 100% necessary for a monster, but it's a nice bonus. Alright, so I'm not seeing any illusionary walls. At least not... not that are apparent. There might be a button on a wall. Again, great. Because we all know how much I love buttons on walls. Oh well, at least there are no dark areas here yet. I'm sure there will be. Alright, not seeing any illusionary walls. Start looking for a button, I guess. Of course, it's possible that I'll just make my perception check and my character will say, hey, that's an... Oh, okay. Weird. I didn't notice this first time through. I didn't make my real life perception check that time. Pretty sure it's Otiug. Because I remember it's spelled like O-T-Y-U-G or something. And I remember thinking it should be pronounced Otiug or Otiug, but the manual says Otiug, at least I'm pretty sure. Feeling pretty good about these monsters. You know, not to be a jerk about it or anything, but I've dealt with far, far worse than these. Now the wyvern does not make a very pleasant noise. There really are no pleasant noises in this game. Well, I do like the eating noise. That's pretty good. It's a very satisfying kind of sound. But that's it. That's my only moment of satisfaction in an otherwise nightmarish realm. Hey, Wyvern. You know, I should equip my shield now that I'm not dealing with fears. My armor class, a better armor class, is actually helpful. I kind of want to just let these things hit me and see if they do have any acid or poison attacks or anything. But at least I know what I'm dealing with. Wow, there's a lot of enemies here. I should probably get to a choke point. By the way, the music is a symphonic arrangement of Chrono Trigger. Not sure if I mentioned that yet or not. Chrono Trigger is pretty much the perfect video game soundtrack, so you can't really improve on it. But it is cool to get kind of a different perspective on it. Get a symphonic arrangement. Wand of Fire. Oh, hey. I have two of those, don't I? Yeah, I do. And a Wand of Magic Missile. I have all kinds of stuff that I'm not using. Maybe some of that stuff would have been useful against the fears. I don't know. I did use a Wand of Fire a little bit in the last video. A very strangely shaped room. I don't think I've seen a room like that in Dungeon Hack yet. You know, no offense, buddy, but you might want to start thinking about just running. This is that potion of water, right? Does it taste awful? I don't know if that means it's poison or not, though. Tangerine potion. How much you want to bet it doesn't taste like tangerines? No, you can say one thing about this game. Very educational. I've learned all kinds of new colors from it. Of course, I can't remember them, but I learned them at some point. If I go back and watch my videos, then I will recall that knowledge. Boy, these things really don't stand a chance against me, do they? Those are wyverns, right? I want to double check. Yeah, okay. Autiugs and wyverns. I'm a monster encyclopedia. Chrome or... Yep, Chrome. Chrome or Firefox? You know, I'm not going to complain about an easy level after that last one. That's not a... I need a gold key. See, where have I not been? I haven't been down this hallway. Okay. You know, I wonder if it's possible for the game to put a key behind a locked door, or if it's programmed well enough that doesn't happen. Oh yeah, the Sheik Ghoul I fought 11 levels ago. Awesome. Pretty sure it's not possible to get permanently stuck in this game. Like, because of a glitch where a key doesn't show up. Unless you play more than 20 levels. There is a glitch where if you go past level 20, well no, I think 20 is the max. Maybe it's past level 18. I know that after a certain point it's possible to get a glitch where items just no longer show up and you can't progress because the keys to doors aren't showing up. Which is why 18 is pretty much the max you want to play. I think 19 is safe. 20 might be the only level that's messed up, that's potentially messed up like that. Giving me a lot more treasure now too, it seems. Now that I don't need it quite as much. Hey, he actually hit me for 3 damage. Good job. Okay, I'll stop being an ass. It's just so satisfying after the last level to be able to just breeze through the monsters like this. I have to say it's not great game balance either. Having such a difficult level followed by such an easy one. I mean, I know it's randomized and you know, to a certain extent the monsters are you know, there's no rhyme or reason to where the monsters are placed. But you know, they could have said that these monsters only show up at this tier of levels of the dungeon or something like that. So that all the toughest monsters were at the higher levels of the dungeon, or the lower levels, I should say. I don't know. I guess it's fine. An illusionary wall there. Thanks, Trucy. Okay, there's the lock that I need that green hammer for. So I have to get to the other side of that door. Okay, so I still need to use my gold key, right? Where was that? Or I think the gold key was there. Let's see what's at the end of this hallway first. Okay, I'm in another no magic zone, but I should be okay. I wonder if the no magic zones affect the monsters. I'm gonna say probably not. It probably only affects spells, and none of the monsters actually cast spells. They just have, like, magical attacks. Okay, so I need to... Right, that's a green gong. So I need to head down here. Or walk right into the rocks. Not too fond of this arrangement of the battle music. I don't know, it doesn't really seem to fit the spirit of what the original soundtrack was going for. You know, I'd expect something a little more hard driving, something with a little more percussion. I guess it has some in there, but it's not nearly as intense as I'd like it to be. Four points of damage, eh? Well, wow, my armor class is actually minus 6 now. I didn't notice that. I guess it's because I didn't have my shield equipped for most of the last few videos. Iron. You know, these things just look goofy. They don't look threatening at all. Wyverns look pretty cool, though. I could probably go dual hammers in this one. Through this a little more quickly. I think I'll try that after I kill these two monsters. I haven't gone dual hammers yet in this LP. That's a pretty cool way to play this game. Hey, you. Uh-oh. I'm trapped. Whatever will I do? You know, I should really shut the hell up, because I know as soon as I say something like that, these things are going to vomit plutonium onto me or something. Alright, those wyverns actually, they can hit pretty hard. So after I kill these two, I'm going ahead and heal. You used to call me Duke Two Hammers Bumpington. That was my nickname back in college. The funny story behind that name. Story I don't have time to get into right now. Oh no. I mean, it is a little disappointing that I just kind of stuck with the spiritual hammer through pretty much this whole run. I mean, the run's not over yet, but you know. I'm feeling a lot more confident now. Go ahead and get my prayer back on. Right, there's a red keyhole on that side that I haven't found the key for yet. But I'm pretty much done in this section of the dungeon anyway, so no big deal if I don't find that. You know, the only thing I like better than a hammer is two hammers. Pretty much the only way to improve on the whole hammer experience. You know, if Apple sold hammers in the Apple store, when you go in to buy an official Apple brand hammer, the genius working there would probably say, you know, why not two hammers? And you'd be like, yeah, I guess you know what you're talking about, Apple employee. And then you'd have two hammers, and you'd be very happy. Right, where do I have to go next? a little suspicious about this section of the dungeon here. There's probably a secret door somewhere that I didn't see. But I'm gonna go up and check out this door first. Forget if I have the key that I need for that or not. I mean, I could have gone two hammers. Oh yeah, that's right. That's the gong. Oh wait. I was on the other side and I didn't go in there? That's weird. Yeah, up until this point, things were always tough enough that I wanted either my shield or my holy symbol in my other hand. Now I think I'm doing okay. Fire 1, fire 2. Alright, let's go ahead and open this just for posterity. Maybe a little prosperity. I guess I didn't cast True Seeing again. Well, I should go ahead and do that. I guess I haven't rested in a while. I don't think I have a True Seeing spell ready at the moment. No. Well, let's go ahead and rest, I guess. Create food and water while we're here. Cast healing spells, even though I don't really need it. I'm in a good mood for this video, guys. I am glad level 12 is over. Over and done for. Done with. Alright, True Seeing, that's... there we go. Wow, this video might actually be done in less than half an hour. That'll be a first for this series. Alright, there must be an illusionary wall down here that I didn't see. Check it out. Am I going the right way? No. I guess I could have gone that way, but it's a little bit faster to circle around this way. Oh yeah, that's right. Chainmail. Not necessary, but appreciated. Oh hey. What do you know? I was looking at my map and I didn't even realize that there was no wall there until I stepped into it. Would you look at that? Oh hey! I fought these before, haven't I? I fought those a long time ago. Potion of speed, potion of clearness. What was that? That was a... what was that thing called? It's like a watch ghost, wasn't it? Or maybe I think that was a sword wraith, actually. I thought those, like, geez, back on level 3 or something. Guess what, guys? Boom. Level 13. Done. In 23 minutes. 24 minutes. And Ettins. I think I can deal with those. Alright, this has been Let's Play Dungeon Hack. Redux. We're on our way, guys. We only have 4 levels to go. I'm excited. See you tomorrow. Goodbye.